everybody, Josh the RV Nerd down here at Advantage One RV today with a little 16T Apex Terra. This is actually a miniature subset of the Apex family you might not have heard of. They came out right before the whole pandemic thing happened, so they never really had their chance to kind of shine in the sun when they launched. The idea here is if you take an Apex Nano, which is 7.5 foot wide, and you compress it down a little bit more, we get a 7 foot wide Asdel little ultralight. And this one right here is about as close to brand new as you're gonna find in the used RV market. I know I've said that a lot a couple times lately, but it's absolutely true. This is actually a customer who did purchase this from us down at Haylet RV. It is between 2,800, 2,900 pounds. I don't know if I mentioned that. I have a lot running through my mind because I wanna tell you a lot about this one. But I guess another way I could say this, it's almost like a Coachman Geo Pro, if that makes sense. It's an Asdel little lightweight. It's got the off-road package, tank heaters, solar package. It's got a cargo door in the back. And like the beds, the dinette, all this stuff flips up out of the way. So where I could see this being really awesome, somebody who wants to like bicycles, dog crates, kayaks. This would be a really good kayak hauler. It's made for people who, maybe you spend a little bit of time in the parks, but sometimes you want to get out in the sticks and the bricks and the blood and the mud. That's where this one's gonna come into play right here. And you're getting it at a pre-owned price tag. Bonus! Now, one of the coolest things about this camper is the way that you can use it in different almost modes. Like right now, I've got it in like cargo travel mode. You see that on the rear wall that we're looking at, that rear bed can flip up. That's a 54 by 80 inch bed, by the way. So if you're tall like me, you actually can comfortably lay down across that. But every single thing gets out of the way and you have like this full on front to back cargo corridor right here, or even all the way up to the front nose of the RV. Everything can be wide open. So if you've got some really big, really long stuff, or if you like to pack heavy in a little camper, this little guy can get the job done. And while it's also kind of cool that you can use that like an open lounge, and this does fold down into a sleeper if need be, you take a look here, that's going to be your primary dining space, but it has a large table. But since it's free floating, you can take it outside if you want. Now, both that table and the kitchen counters, and even the bathroom counter actually, they're all a sealed edge press membrane. So if it is a little bit humid, if you happen to spill something, no big deal. Wipe it down. Not gonna really screw anything up. Household and USB outlets down there where you're gonna be sitting. This is a 6 cubic foot gas electric two-way fridge, which is actually very effective for off-grid camping since the propane side doesn't really can tax your like electrical battery reserves too awful heavily, since the propane itself is doing the heavy lifting. You do though, if you are going to be in a park, this isn't just an off-grid camper. You've got yourself a 13,500 BTU air conditioner up there, which in this little box is gonna be way more than enough. But what's also nice is the off-grid package this one has includes that extra large max air vent fan right there. We'll skip over to that bathroom in just a second, but first want to pop over here. I like the location of the stereo unit on this, and it does have HDMI and USB plugs, and it's Bluetooth and all those nice things. But if you just want to be able to pop in the door, go beep, turn something on or off, tune to your favorite radio station, it's right there. And the switches are all up high. So if you are camping with, say, like a little kid or something like that, the switches aren't really down where they can reach them. I love the window coverage on this, but you notice that you do have those nice kind of privacy shades as well. But that big window overlook of the kitchen to me is awesome, because basically where I'm standing right now, if I actually sit down, this is what it looks like when you're sitting in the dinette. You know, if you're sitting here playing cards, chewing the fat, shooting the breeze, this is what she's going to look like. And just so you know, it is not a head knocker down here. You can see that I've got, even with my hat sitting upright, ET phone home neck stretch, I'm not clocking my noggin on this thing. So it does comfortably fit adults here. Is this the biggest camper? No, but am I feeling claustrophobic? No, not at all. Even when I'm kind of over here in this little refrigerator corner. I really like what they did with the kitchen counter on this though. It's all sealed edge press membrane, and everything folds down. You've got that flush mount sink cover. It's a stainless sink. You've got that flip top kind of almost truck camper style, very space efficient, very effective little burner arrangement right there. That is also doubling as our backsplash. No oven, but a microwave oven down below, which is actually an arrangement that I like quite a bit. And they give you just enough space for some things like, you know, some dish soaps and whatnot. You got plywood extension drawers out here that you can actually load up. You know, they're not made out of particle board and beaver puke. The overhead cabinet space there, you can see. A little overhead space like this. This is the reason, actually, the microwave is mounted down here. Because what it allowed them to do was give you a bigger cabinet overhead overall. Now, one of the only changes or modifications the previous owner made is not actually a modification technically at all. They just hung a giant mirror on the bathroom door right there. And it's not even really like, it's not glued or anything or stapled to it. Staples don't really go through glass all that well, I've found. Only took me a couple times of hanging a mirror in my house to figure that one out. But the bathroom here, it's simple, compact, small, but it's got just enough in the right places. Looks like the previous owner on that little shelf right there added a little cabinet. They added another mirror on that wall, and especially that mirror plus that window right there and the big mirror on the door. This bathroom opens right up, and it doesn't feel extremely restrictive, which is actually kind of nice. Another part of the off-grid package on this one is the shower miser, which from Halet RV you're probably very familiar with on things like the Rockwood Geo Pros, but there are more than one company that certainly use those, and this would be an example. I'm not sure that shower is ever used, in case you're curious about the, that's not like remnants of a crime scene and blood splatters, that's just a little pink antifreeze keeping the water lines protected for you. And it also just occurred to me, I realized, wait a minute, this, when this was brand new, it didn't have a TV right there. I started tracing the conduit. The owner added all that, and they did a really nice job of it, actually. They ran some coax, and actually they ran this coax line down into what we'll see as a mini camp kitchen. So you've actually got hookup for an outside TV that wasn't on here when it was brand new. And they ran the power lines and the coax over here above the bed where there's some power outlets. They did a really nice job of that, actually. I didn't even catch it when I first went through this camper. Nice work. I do like the color package on that. That has a good look, good decal package. It's just very nice striking lines about it. And a lot of window coverage for such a small trailer and good awning coverage for such a small trailer. Now, it's not a 35-foot awning, but it ain't a 35-foot camper. I think they did the best they could here. You see those stable steps taking the wiggle jiggle out of it? What is also helping that is not just the four-corner stabilizers, but if you look at them, they're actually angled. And if you talk to anybody who has camped with angled stabilizers, they always say that it stabilizes better than when they're just facing front to back. Now, this is a 7-foot camper. A lot of the smaller Apexes, like the Nanos, are 7'6". Again, this is an even smaller compact little class, but you got the bike rack on the front. You've got the toy lock there to keep your bikes kind of in check. And again, when we see the cargo space on this one more time, I mean, there's just not much you can't do with it. Oh, you know what else this would be really cool for? Is like game day tailgating. That would be awesome. Black tank flush right there. Again, the off-road package applied to this one. I believe that was called the Extreme Package or something like that. You can see that the tires are not all weather checked and worn out. Everything on this is basically new. But things like a black tank flush and an outside utility shower on a small trailer like this, those are really handy features that a lot of little camper brands just don't always include. But storage is such a critical deal, especially on a small trailer. And I tell you what, they got pretty creative and pretty crafty with this. And again, you're going to see some extras provided from the one and only previous owner who barely ever used the thing. Like, you've got Camco leveling blocks and some nice wheel chocks in there. Once again, we have that rear cargo door. Now, that can deadbolt, by the way, so you don't got to worry about some gas station murder hobo opening the door in the middle of the night and stabbing you to death, because, you know, you can have that locked and stay nice and safe and secure. Now, this is another good place to get to see, like, this is an all-aluminum skeleton, and they're even building that bed lift right there out of aluminum. And again, if you get that front table even out of the way, you've got, like, what, 16-foot-ish of front-to-back potential loading space. So there's a lot of things in this industry that'll say, oh, you could haul a kayak in this. But yeah, maybe if you have an 8-foot kayak, what about a 10 or a 12-foot for a bigger fat dude like me? Well, I could actually keep a decent-sized kayak in this thing. That being said, I got a, because I'm not very outdoorsy, I got a little
8-foot kayak myself that I'm technically overweight and overrated for. I haven't gone in the soup yet, but it's gonna happen one of these days, I'm sure. Little mini camp kitchenette over here, a little cooker that slides out, but you can also recess that back when you don't need it. And like I said, that'd be an awesome little game day arrangement with that little propane cooker hooker down below there. We already kind of, you can see the off-road tires, the stable steps. But another very nice thing left by the previous owner is the Recurve R3 hitching system that we actually set them up with here. So not only are you getting a virtually new trailer, they've added accessories to it, some of which were a couple hundred bucks worth, and you're getting it at a used RV price tag. All of these things are a winning combination. Now, something we haven't seen and I haven't mentioned really, I haven't really explained how this is an Azdel ultralight RV. Right below the fiberglass skin, you do have Azdel layering. If you're not super familiar with that, let us know and we can give you some more info. But another thing you can't really see just from this angle is up top, this does have a raised panel high efficiency 100 watt solar package. Now that is not the be all end all of solar. That is an excellent battery tender package and will give you some really, really extended use of things like lights and fans if you're gonna be off grid. But what's cool is with the cargo space on this, if you got a little portable generator, which we can offer you down at Haylet RV and package all together on this if you're interested. Uh-oh, ambulance. I don't know if you can hear that, but hopefully everybody's okay. I hate seeing that. But my, back to the task at hand, sorry. Just, you know, I get concerned about people in my local community here. We've got portable generators. That's the biggest thing I was saying. If you want to put one in that cargo space when you're going down the road, this is an easy one to be able to haul that stuff, then unload it, set up camp when you get there. So if you like what you see, if you're looking to, you know, kind of forge your own path, blaze your own trail, I could see this one working for you and for a nice spot less than a brand new copy of something like this today, which is always a good thing, especially when you're basically getting a brand new RV. Even the hitching, again, hitching included from the previous owners. All they did was add a couple things to it. They had it stored inside. They never beat it up. It's a winner. It's an absolute winner. So if you like her, give us a call. We can get you financed. We've got hitching pieces, parts, trades, and everything else in between. All we need is a chance to work with you. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and have an A1 day, everyone.